فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
علي بن عمر, whose name is Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, may Allah be pleased with him and his father. Okay, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Bunya al-Islamu ala khamsin. Ma ma'ana Bunya al-Islamu ala khamsin? Islam has been built on five foundations, on five pillars. The word Bunya shows that the religion is da'aim. It's a house and it's building, it's got pillars that are holding the built house. So if you break this pillar, the house will collapse. Sahih? So your five, ولذلك, some of the scholars, after the shahadatain, which is unanimously agreed upon, the scholars, there are some who made takfir on a person based on the mabani ul-arba'ah. It's known as what? Mabani ul-arba'ah. And this is qawlun Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Imam Ahmad used to believe that anybody who leaves the salah is a kafir, and who leaves the zakat is a kafir, and he leaves the siyam, fasting, is a kafir, and he leaves the hajj is kafir. Those four. And it's also narrated from him, Imam Ahmad, that it's not only the salah. Are you with me? Rahimahullah wa rahmatan wasi'ah. It's narrated from him. So the religion is built on these five. The first one is shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. The testament shahadatain, which is what? There's none worthy of worship except who? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So what does shahadatu an la ilaha illallah mean? La ma'buda bihaqin illallah. La ma'buda bihaqin illallah. So if somebody asks you what is la ma'buda, ma'bud means ibadah. So if somebody asks what's the definition of ibadah, the scholars, they divide the ibadah into two, at ta'abud, which then becomes the fi'l of the action that the person is doing, and he has to do with two pillars, which is kamalul dhulli ma'a kamalil mahabba. And we will leave off the word al-dhul and we'll say khudu', kamalul khudu' ma'a kamalil mahabba. But then the other categorization is al-muta'abbadu bihi, which is what Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah mentioned in his kitab al-ubudiyyah. He says that al-ismu jami'u li kulli ma yuhibbuhu Allah wa yardah min al-aqwali wal-a'mali al-zahirati wal-batina, which is it's a general term, everything which Allah loves and is pleased with. It's an action which is internal and it's external. Anything that falls under that definition we just gave is basically ibadah, and you can't divert it for anybody other than Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. إذن من صرف عبادة لغير الله فقد أشرك. Anyone who diverts ibadah of Allah to anybody other than Allah, he has fallen into shirk. He has fallen into a shirk. So ibadah is the haqq of who? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Then when a person says ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, it is what? Ifradul ibadati lillahi, singling ibadah for Allah. But when you say wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, is what? Ifradul ittiba'i lil rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah means what? Singling Allah in worship. But then when you say wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah means what? Singling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in following him. You single him and follow him alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ولذلك the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is what? Abdun fala yu'bad wa nabiyyun فلا يكذب ولكن يطاع ويتبع. The Prophet ﷺ is a slave, he's not worshipped. And he's a prophet, he's not disbelieved in. Rather, he is followed and he's obeyed. He's followed and he's obeyed. And from that statement, what comes from it? That you don't fool when it comes to the Prophet, إفراط ولا تفريط. You don't go overboard on him, so you don't worship him. And you don't go short, then you don't just treat him like a normal human being. Okay? So you give him the rights that he owns. What's the rights that he owns? That he's a slave. That he's not Allah, he's not worshipped, that's the station. So he's below Allah. But he's higher than an ordinary person, because Allah made him a Nabi, and he sent him. وَلِذَلِكَ the times when the Prophet ﷺ was at the best positions, Allah referred to him as a slave. So there's no station a person can get better than be a slave. Allah says, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ الْفُرْقَانَ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ. He's talking about the Qur'an. He sent it down on who? His slave. He didn't say his prophet, he didn't say his messenger, he said slave. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى وأنه لما قام عبد الله. Allah tells us all of those times the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is referring to him as a what? As a slave. Allah is taking him up in the sky, ليلة السراء والمعراج, Allah refers to him as a slave. The time when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Quran has been sent on him, Allah said, I sent it down on my slave. The time when the Prophet ﷺ stood to do da'wah, وَأَنَّهُ لَمَّا قَامَ يَدْعُوهُ كَادُ وَأَنَّهُ لَمَّا قَامَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ يَدْعُوهُ كَادُ يَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِ لِبَدًا. That when the Prophet ﷺ stood up to give da'wah and call to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he referred to him as a slave. So these are the maqamat, the positions when there's honor, but Allah referred to him as a slave. So my beloved brothers and sisters, a lot of the youngsters who are on the streets who think they want to be bad boys, remember you are slave. Don't fight with that. ولذلك, anybody who believes he's a slave has to humble himself and stop being arrogant. And so that's why a lot of the youngsters who actually walk in the way they walk, dropping their trousers is a khalal in the understanding of ubudiyah, servitude. Because as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحَا إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَخْرِقَ الْأَرْضَ وَلَنْ تَبْلُغَ الْجِبَالَ طُولًا. Don't walk like the way you walk sideways and be like you're as a bad boy. For verily you cannot crack this earth that you're walking on, and you're not as tall as the mountains. Who from the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك, anyone who prays the salah, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. The salah prevents you from what? Evil and going against Allah's command. Does it not? How does it do it? Because when you pray the salah and you truly understand what you're reciting, for example, the verses that you recite is Surah Al-Fatiha, which you have to read at least 17 times a day. You say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ, which is إِفْرَادُ bil ibadah. You're singling Allah in ibadah, so you're getting rid of what? Showing off. And then what's it? وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, you're getting rid of what? Arrogance. You're saying, I haven't got power, oh Allah, help me. Those are the two things that are missing from the gangsters. Isn't that the case? They want to show off what they don't have. Is that what they call it? Bling bling. Isn't that what they call it? They got cars, they got flashy things. They want to be what they're not, so they're showing off. That's true. I just want to show you, brothers, that aqeedah can solve any problem that you guys have. And it's not just a theoretical thing. You can solve gangsters' life just bullahi and tawheed and aqeedah and ibadah, ma'an al ibadah bis. But do we truly understand how we can solve problems and how we can go into these issues? So he wants to show off, which is إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. He should have showed off. وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, which gets rid of what? Arrogance. Look at how arrogant he is. He wants to get respect on the streets. He wants to be known on the streets. He wants his name to be up there on the streets. The truth of the matter is what? This earth that you're walking on, مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. The earth that you're walking on, the way you're walking on right now, is going to swallow you, it's going to eat you. And nothing's going to be left of you. Nothing's going to be left of you. So you're forgetting your true essence. You're forgetting what? Your true essence and what you truly mean. Sahih? So, ifradullahi bil ibadah, single Allah in slave, servitude, and be a true slave of His subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah means that you follow the Prophet in everything. Brothers, if you have the Prophet, why are you following somebody else for? Somebody will say, wallahi, I love the Prophet. If I ask the gangsters and the youngsters on the street, yeah, and you say, do you love the Prophet? You'll say, I like him. I love him. Sahih? And he's praiseworthy for saying that. But is that true when you're saying that? تعصي الإله وأنت تزعم حبه هذا لعمرك في القياس شنيع لو كان حبك صادقا لأطعته إن المحب لمن يحب مطيع. You disobey Allah and you claim His love. You disobey the Prophet and you claim His love. If a wife, she requests her husband to go and get her something and he says, no, I'm not going to get it. I was going to go, but now that you told me, I'm not going to go. And then he tells her later, wow, I love you so much. You're the most beloved person to me. Would she accept that from him? Vice versa. If husband told his wife, you know, do this. And whatever he told her, she always done the opposite. And then he tells her, I love you. Or she tells him that she loves him. Would he accept that from her? The point of the matter is, your love has to show in your limbs. And it has to manifest in your limbs. وَلِذَلِكَ اللَّهِ تَبَارِكَ وَتَعَالَى conditioned your love, whether it's true or not, on what, if you follow the Prophet. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. If you love Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and your love is true about Allah, then we'll look at it and believe that when we see how you follow the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So brothers and sisters, take time from learning in your tawheed and studying it. Learn what la ilaha illallah means and what it entails from you. Learn what ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah means and what it entails from you, what it requires from you. ولذلك Allah says in the Quran, فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ. Know that there's none worthy of worship. Al-ilm, which is what is ilm? Huwa idraku al-shay ala ma huwa alayhi idrakan jazima. Knowledge is to know something as it is. I mean, to perceive something as it is with unwavering conviction. That's what knowledge is. So you need to know la ilaha illallah properly. And you have to study it. When you go to the grave, the three questions that you're going to be asked is what? Man rabbuk, wa ma nabiyuk, wa ma deenuk. And you're going to have to answer what? Man rabbuk. Rabbi Allahu alladhi khalaqani wa rabbani wa rabba jami' al-alamin bi na'mi wa huwa ma'budi laysa li ma'budun siwa. You're going to be asked, what's your religion? Deen al-Islam. You're going to be asked about your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you can't even say his third name. You say that I know the Prophet, but you're asked now in this world, what's his third name? You don't even know it. But if I ask you about a football player, you know five names of his, how much he was bought by each team, and how much is he being sold for right now, and what car he drives, and where he lives, you know it. That's the truth of the matter. So the truth is that your love of the Prophet ﷺ, it shows how much you want to learn and know about his religion, and how eager you are for it, and how much you want to understand about it. Naam. So that's what ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah means. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, ikhwani, it is not mujarradi da'awa. It is not mere claims. It is not الدعوة ما لم تقيم ببينات أبناؤها أدعياء. No one can just come and claim what they want. Whatever you claim, you have to back it up with actions. Okay? I can go and claim and say, wow, you know what? This masjid is mine. I own it. I bought it. Would that work? Claiming is the easiest thing a person can do. Everything which you claim, you have to show it with your actions. So if you love the Prophet ﷺ, he's the most beloved to you, then let this the Prophet ﷺ, his, how he looked and how he was, let it be seen on you. So study La ilaha illallah. ولذلك the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came to the noble companion Abu Dharr. You know, he came to the noble companion Ubay ibn Ka'b. He said, Ubay, do you know أعظم آية في كتاب الله, the greatest verse in the Quran? Do you know the greatest verse in the Quran? And then what did he respond by saying? Ayatul Kursi. And that shocks me, because how did Abu Ubay really know the answer to that question? Because how many verses does he have? Over 6,000 and something verses in the Quran. How did he select the right answer from all of those verses? How did he know? You know how he could only have known? Because he must have known the Prophet ﷺ is how serious he is on the issue of Tawheed. And that's why he could have picked that verse out of all the other ayat that are in the Quran. He said, Ayatul Kursi, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, la ta'khudhuhu sinatun wa la nawm, lahu ma fi samawati wa ma fi al-ard, ila akhir al-ayat. And then when he answered it, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, liyahnika al-ilma ya Aba al-Mundhir, may Allah soften and may Allah place knowledge for you, Abu Mundhir. Because he got it accurately and correctly right. Ayatul Kursi, what's the value of Ayatul Kursi over all of the other surahs in the Quran? Why does this ayah have unique? Because Ayatul Kursi is what? It talks about Tawheed and Aqeedah. It solidifies a person's belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ, I swear by the Lord, Muhammad's nafs is in his soul. لَا يَسْمَعُ بِأَحَدٌ مِّنْ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ يَهُودِيٌ أَوْ نَصْرَانِي ثُمَّ يَمُوتُ وَهُوَ لَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِالَّذِي أُرْسِلْتُ بِهِ إِلَّا كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ. That no one hears about me, whether he's a Christian or a Jew. He doesn't hear about me and does not believe in me, except he's going to be from the people of the hellfire. He has to believe in me. ولذلك the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه reading the Torah, and he said, what are you reading, Umar? Umar said, I'm reading Torah. And he said to him, why are you reading the Torah? والله لو كان موسى حيا لما وسعه إلا أن يتبعني. والله, if Musa was alive, he would have no other choice except to follow me. What are you reading Torah for? If Musa was alive, there would be no other choice given to him except to follow me, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then وإقام الصلاة, establishing the prayer. إخواني, الصلاة is عباد الدين. It is the foundation, it is the backbone of your religion. ولذلك the scholars are of different opinions whether the person who leaves the salah is a kafir. And I'm more inclined to the opinion that says anyone who leaves the salah is a kafir. I'm of that opinion, and I feel like that opinion has more stronger evidences. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, العهد الذي بيننا وبينهم الصلاة فمن تركها فقد كفر. That the covenant between us and them is what? As-salah. Anyone who leaves it is a disbeliever. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, Allah says in the Quran, فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّا. Then a nation came, a group of people came. They forsake the prayer, and what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّا. They forsake the prayer, Allah is going to make them taste غَيَّا. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said what? This is a wadi fi jahannam, it's a valley in the hellfire. That's where they're going to go to. So if you don't pray the salah, my beloved brothers and sisters, and you're going to, the hadith tells us, the person who doesn't pray, يَأْتِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ لَيْسَ لَهُ نُورٌ وَلَا بُرْهَانٌ وَلَا حُجَّةٌ. He has no light, he has no proof, he has no evidences, and he will be resurrected with who? قَارُونَ هَامَانَ and Ubay ibn Khalaf. رُؤُوسُ الْكَفَرَةِ, the heads of disbelief, he'll be resurrected with them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that. ولذلك Allah tells us in the Quran, مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ وَلَمْ نَكُنْ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ وَكُنَّا نَخُوضُ مَعَ الْخَائِذِينَ وَكُنَّا نُكَذِّبُ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينَ حَتَّى أَتَانَ الْيَقِينَ. They're going to be in the hellfire, so they're going to be asked, what brought you to the hellfire? And from the things that they mentioned, the reason why they come to the hellfire is, وَقَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ, we were not those who used to pray. So if you haven't chose to put your forehead on the ground for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, then why do you expect, why do you expect Allah to have mercy upon you? Ikhwani, after the shahadatain, when the person says, Ashhadu la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, the first thing that is needed from them is the salah. They have to pray. ولذلك Allah says in the Quran, يَوْمَ يُكْشَفُ عَنْ سَاقٍ وَيُدْعَوْنَ إِلَى السُّجُودِ فَلَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ. Allah is going to unveil his shin, and then everyone is going to prostrate for him. Imam Ahmad said, rahimahullah ta'ala, that the person who won't be able to prostrate, that the person who will not be able to prostrate is the one who never used to pray. ولذلك Iblis عليه العائن الله, may Allah's consistent and continuous curse be upon him. Iblis, what did he do? He refused to prostrate to Allah. he refused to prostrate based on Allah's command. When he was told to prostrate for Adam, he refused to prostrate. Then why are you refusing to prostrate? Are you going to take the path of Iblis? Allah said to you, أَلَمْ أَعْهَدْ إِلَيْكُمْ يَا بَنِي آدَمَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا الشَّيْطَانِ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. Did I not take a covenant with you and an oath not to worship shaytan? For verily, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala wants you to worship him alone. So the person should realize, my beloved brothers and sisters, honor and success and prosperity that you're looking for is into praying. ولذلك the Prophet used to find joy in the prayer. He would say to the companion, Bilal, يا بلال أرحنا بالصلاة. Bilal, bring us comfort and tranquility through the salah. So the Prophet, whenever if something was hard on him and he was going through a hard time, he would find joy in the prayer. He would find what? He would find joy in the prayer because he was a true slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the next one is what? وَصَوْمُ Ramadan. And the fasting of what? The month of Ramadan. No, وَالْحَجْ. Sorry, وَإِيْتَاءِ الزَّكَاتِ. Giving the zakat. The zakat which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made obligatory on his slaves. وَالْحَجْ. And hajj in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made obligatory on the people. قَالَ تَعَالَى Allah says, وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah tells us in that verse that upon the people is what? Hajj of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which they need to come with once in a lifetime. And also what falls under hajj is umrah. Umrah is obligatory once in a lifetime. Umrah, according to the strongest opinion of the scholars, is that it is wajib marratan fil umri, just like hajj is obligatory once in a lifetime. وَصَوْمُ Ramadan, and also fasting in the month of Ramadan. It's obligatory on every what? مُسْلِمٌ مُكَلَّفٌ بَالِغٌ عَاقِلٌ صَحِيحٌ مُقِيمٌ. It's obligatory on every Muslim who's reached age of puberty, who is sane, who is healthy, who's a resident. If he's a traveler, this is... Are you with me, brothers? And of course, مُسْتَطِيعٌ, he's able to do that, he's not ill. The person has to come with the fasting of the month of Ramadan. Why did he mention jihad? Scholars, they spoke, why is in the five pillars of Islam never jihad mentioned in it? The scholars, they said because jihad, the asal of it is that it's fardu kifayah. It's not fardu ayn. These are fardu ayn. Fardu kifayah means what? إِذَا قَامَ بِهِ إِبَعْضٌ سَقَطَ عَنِ الْبَاقِينَ. If some people do it, the rest, they don't have to do it. صح؟ Whereas salah, siyam, hajj, sawm are all fardu ayn. Everybody has to do it for himself. No one else will take it for you. You know, when you teach classes for so long and you're teaching, at the beginning everybody was smiling and now faces are just like... I can see faces already, people's faces. Hey, yeah, fadhal, read next hadith. We're still not there yet. We only took one hadith, right? This is one hadith. We've got 58 to go, 57 to go.
باب أمور الإيمان وقول الله تعالى ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب ولكن البر آمن بالله
ولكن البر من آمن
ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر
ولكن البر
ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين وآت المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل والسائلين وفي الرقاب وأقام الصلاة وآت الزكاة والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا والصابرين في البأساء والضراء وحين البأس أولئك الذين صدقوا وأولئك هم المتقون قد أفلح المؤمنون الآية شكرا
ناجز لله
Chapter, what is said regarding the deeds of faith and the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not al-birr that you turn your faces to east and west, but al-birr the one who believes in Allah, the last day, the angels, the book, the prophets, and gives his wealth in spite of the love for it, to the kinsfolk and to the orphans, and to al-masakeen, the poor, and to the wayfarer, and to those who ask, and to set slaves free, and to perform as-salah, and gives the zakat, and who fulfill their covenant when they make it, and who are patient in severe poverty and ailment, disease, and at the time of fighting during the battles. Such are the people of truth, and they are al-muttaqoon. Successful indeed are the believers.
Al-Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, he said, Babu umur al-Iman, matters pertaining to Iman. So here we're going to know mujmal shu'ab al-Iman. He's actually trying to throw Iman has different branches. Some of the branches are asal, some of the branches are wajibat, some of the branches are mustahabbat. And this ayah combines all of them. ولذلك الله says at the ending أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. These are the people who are truthful about their iman. How are they truthful? They didn't just claim it. Because Allah tells us in the Quran حَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. When you say I'm a believer, you have to be tested. Okay, let's see. How do you get tested? Different ways. Allah will test you to see that you're saying, I'm a believer, is it real or is it not? Are you there? Walidharik, if you go for a job right now and you want to work, they give you a probation period, right? Where they test you to see you, okay? Okay? And if they feel like you're good and you're qualified, they'll keep you. They'll give you a long-term contract. If they feel like within that probation period that you're not good enough, they'll tell you to go. So they want to see the CV that you put forward, are you really what you claim? So now that you said, أنا مؤمنون, inshallah. Okay? Let's put it to the test. Do you follow these characteristics? ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب. It's not that you face مشرق or مغرب. That remember the Sahaba قد نرى تقلب وجهك في السماء فلنولينك قبلا ترضاها فولي وجهك شطر المسجد الحرام وحيثما كنتم. The Prophet, remember, they wanted to face Mecca over Bayt al-Maqdis. That's what they wanted. And they kept looking, the Prophet kept looking at the sky. Allah was saying to them, listen, whether you face Bayt al-Maqdis, or whether you face the Kaaba, that's not what righteousness is connected to. Are you there? But what righteousness is connected to, birr, righteousness is connected to is what? مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالْكِتَابِ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ وَآتَ الْمَالَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ ذَوِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَ وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ وَالسَّائِلِينَ وَفِي الرِّقَابِ وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتَ الزَّكَاةَ وَالْمُوفُونَ بِعَهْدِهِمْ إِذَا عَاهَدُوا وَالصَّابِرِينَ فِي الْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَحِينَ الْبَأْسِ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا. These characteristics. Do you have them? Oh, okay. Once you've come with those characteristics, then you're a person who's truthful about it. And then you're from the muttaqin. Also, the qawluhu ta'ala, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ أَلَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. Are you like this? Then you're a successful believer. So he's trying to show you that iman is of branches. That whenever you take you part of iman, there's more to do. There's every time more for you to do. That's what Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe, that when you say Ana Mu'minun, you always say Insha'Allah. Because to fully do all the actions of Iman is very, very hard. Very hard. Na'am.
Hadathana Abdullah ibn Muhammadin.
So we go faster, inshallah. Abdullah ibn Muhammad, his name is Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Ja'far ibn al-Yaman al-Ju'fiyu. He's the Hafid al-Musnadi. Na'am.
قال حدثنا أبو عامر العقدي.
His name is عبد الملك بن عمرو القيسي البصري. هيا.
قال حدثنا سليمان بن بلال.
Who's narrated from after أبو عامر العقدي؟ ها نعم سليمان بن بلال. هيا.
عن عبد الله بن دينار.
نعم.
عن أبي صالح.
أبي صالح هو ذكوان بن سماك.
أبي هريرة.
سماك سوري.
أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه.
ولذلك if you ever hear أبو صالح narrated from أبو هريرة, it's always the person comes to your mind is ذكوان بن سماك. He's him. Abu Salih and Abu Hurairah is him. He's the one whose kunya is very well known as Abu Salih. Or else there are many who narrate from Abu Hurairah that Abu Salih, but the one that when he said unrestrictedly, it is who? Is this one. Abu Hurairah's name is Abdurrahman ibn Sakhrin al-Dawsiyu. His name is differed upon in how many opinions? 30 different names. Ibn Abdul Barr mentions that in his kitab At-Tamheed, 30 different names that were differed upon. But the strongest one is that his name is Abdurrahman ibn Sakhrin. Well, and we still say there's a niza', there's long discussion going on. Hey?
That
the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said,
Al-Iman bid'un wa sittun shu'ba, wal haya'u shu'batun min al-Iman.
Barr mahal. Hey, lahm dakhya idaman. Hey, carry on. Al-Imanu?
بدعٌ وستون شعبة والحياء شعبة من الإيمان.
The iman is what بدعٌ وستون شعبة. What does it mean? It means 60 and odd branches. The iman is. ولذلك الله says in the Quran فلبث في السجن بضع سنين. And بضع starts from what? ثلاث إلى سبع. إلى تسع. It's from 3 to 9. It's those odd numbers. That's why we say 60 and odd numbers. So it can be anywhere from 63 to 69. ولذلك الإمام البيهقي رحمه الله, he wrote a book called كتاب الشعب الإيمان, where he talks about the branches of Iman. So when we say فَلَبِثَ فِي السِّجْنِ بِضْعَ سِنِينَ وَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ غَلَبِهِمْ سَيَغْلِبُونَ فِي بِضْعِ سِنِينَ لِلَّهِ الْأَمْرُ مِنْ بَعْدُ وَمِنْ قَبْلُ, this is what it means. بِضْعُ سِنِينَ is from 3 to 9. We'll stop here inshallah ta'ala. We'll pray salatul asr and we'll come back straight away.